Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board member Eileen Lizade says Grab and Uber riders constitute only a minority of the commuting public, but they're just noisier on social media. Lizada was speaking with transport groups Wednesday, where they slammed the supposed special treatment given by the LTFRB to the ride-hailing companies.
Sila lang ho yung maingay sa social media, but definitely government will not budge. We will not be allowed or influenced because of social media.
But Lizada admits Grab and Uber constitute a lot of riders and drivers. The LTFRB earlier fined the two ride-hailing companies 5 million pesos each for allowing the undocumented drivers to remain on the road despite an earlier LTFRB order. House Majority Leader Rodolfo Fariñas says Congress will form its own technical working group to propose amendments to the 1987 Constitution and pave the way for federalism. Fariñas says the Senate and the House decided to form the technical working group since President Rodrigo Duterte has yet to appoint people to the 25-member consultative body he created in December 2016. The body is supposed to study and recommend constitutional amendments to the Senate and the House, which will then approve, reject, or amend the suggestions. Congress leaders are ironing out the details for the technical working group, but it will be formed by either 6 or 12 legislators from each chamber. The group will recommend amendments to change the form of government to federalism, which will entail dividing the country into autonomous states. Shifting to federalism is one of Duterte's campaign promises. But the working group will prioritize amendments that would support the new draft of the Bangsamoro Basic Law, another priority of the 17th Congress for the next months. Philippine Foreign Secretary Alan Cayetano says the proposed joint development with China in the West Philippine Sea should adhere to Philippine laws if it pushes through. This after President Rodrigo Duterte said in his second State of the Nation address Monday that Filipinos can soon expect joint exploration for oil in the disputed sea. But Cayetano says Manila and Beijing are still talking about principles or framework of a possible agreement.
So kumbaga sa mag-boyfriend, hindi pa yung on na tayo ulit. Nagtinatanong lang kung magkikita ba tayo, may pag-asa ba. Ganun yung level pa lang.
Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi also pushed for joint exploration in the West Philippine Sea on Tuesday during his overnight visit in Manila. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa says residents of parts of Luzon should brace for more rain as Tropical Storm Goryeo enhances the southwest monsoon. As of Wednesday afternoon, Goryeo is located 615 kilometers east of Kasiguran, Aurora, with maximum winds of 75 kilometers per hour and gustiness of up to 90 kilometers per hour. It says while Goryeo itself won't directly affect the Philippines, but it is causing the monsoon rain to become heavier than usual. Pag-asa says the monsoon rain is affecting Metro Manila, Ilocos, Cordillera, Central Luzon, Calabarzon, and Mimaropa. The monsoon rain could trigger flash floods and landslides. There will also be light to moderate rain and thunderstorms in the Visayas as well as Cagayan Valley and Bicol. Vatican Finance Chief Cardinal George Pell denies before an Australian court all charges of historical sexual abuse Wednesday. Pell, the number 3 figure in the Vatican, returned from Rome earlier this month to face the charges in the Melbourne Magistrates Court. Details of the charges have not been made public, but police said they involve multiple complainants. Pell is not required to attend the hearing, but he opted to appear, having previously vowed to defend himself and clear his name.